You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and today we have with us no stranger to Brockton Community Access, cable TV, the screen. I'm going to say the man, but not the myth, the legend, Noube Rateau.
Mark, thanks Welcome. For having me on. Thank
thanks
you so
for
much.
Coming on.
It's always home being here.
Well, you can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave. You know the motto here. You're doing something exciting in the beginning of February, a media workshop right at the Brockton Public Library.
Absolutely.
So, tell us about it.
Well, you know, Mark, I think I've been really blessed. I had so many great people to help me out, such as yourself, Jerry Gibbs, Bridgewater State, that really helped me on my career. And I feel like I'm not young anymore. I'm 31. I'm young, but I'm not, I mean, I'm getting older. So I just wanted to really give back. And I really wanted to give back to the community some things that I've been able to learn the last 10 years since I've graduated Bridgewater State about what it takes to get a job in media. I've been really blessed to, I'm teaching over at Lynn Vocational School, and a lot of my students are going to college. I'm mentoring some students here in Brockton who go Bridgewater State, and a lot of them have the same questions about how to get a job in TV production. So I just think communication is such a broad field. It might be difficult to kind of navigate your way. So I want to do a workshop that kind of highlighted within different people and different expertise on what they should be doing to get a job in the field.
Well, look, you're always giving something back. You came as a volunteer here, TV class, TV club, part-time, full-time, director of communications for the mayor, and now a teacher. So I got to tell you, I'm proud of you, and an award-winning documentarian. So this is great because it's always good to have mentors. I got a few years on you, Noube. You're 31, you're old. I'm 58, I'm 27 years older than you. Come on, I feel like an old dog, let me tell you. But teaching keeps you young.
Absolutely.
And mentoring keeps you young. You had mentors growing up, family members. I was glad to be one of those people.
Absolutely.
But so we get different people coming. You got actors and TV personality, so I got the cheat sheet here, but tell us.
Well, you know, it's funny, you know, I guess my expertise would be probably in more in terms of video editing. Mm-hmm. And I just think, you know, there's so many people who want to become actors and pros and so on and so forth. And I just want to invite different people in those aspects. So we have an actor, Anthony Goss. We have a music producer, Malik Williams. We have two reporters, one from NBC 10, one from Fox 25 News Boston, which is Malcolm Johnson and Crystal Hayes. And we have a local businessman here who's done great things with Anwan Street Productions, that's Rui Lopes. So what's gonna happen is they're gonna talk for about 10 minutes each to kind of give their expertise of what they did and kind of their story of how they got a job. Because we all know in communication, Mark, everyone has a story. You have a story of how you got a job, I got a story, and it's different. So, but I guess the common thing is work ethic, right? And
right.
Being consistent. So they're going to have a chance to talk about their stories. And also, and PCA is going to be involved as well, there's going to be resource tables about different volunteer opportunities that they could have for different public access stations. Mm-hmm. So we're going to have about 10 resource tables, five local access stations, Brockton, and thanks again for being a part of it. Really appreciate
sure.
it. Bridgewater, you know, great partner. Eastern Community Access, Abington, and Whitman Community Access. Ironically, all of them have ties to Brockton, right? Between Eric and Jeff Fowler.
Everybody.
So they're all going to be there. And then we're also going to have the Brockton Cultural Council there. If you're a filmmaker, you want to know how, you know, you want to be able to maybe raise some money for some grants. The Brockton Cultural Council can give you opportunities for that. And let's just say, Mark, that, you know, maybe you've been doing film for a while and think about maybe doing a career change. We're having Sam DePina there, who's one of the vocational directors at Boston English. He's going to talk to people about the steps you should do to be a vocational TV production teacher. Reason being is because a lot of people go to teaching, whether college or high school, for they can do both. They can pursue a passion like I'm doing with documentaries, but also teach to, you know, get the health insurance, get the benefits.
Sure.
And also, you know, work with the kids. So I think it's geared towards college students. But if you're an ambitious high school student, I want you there. If you're a graduate of college and kind of wondering what am I going to do next, I want you there. Or maybe you might be a local businessman or businesswoman that looking for, you know, different freelance videographers. There's going to be plenty of people in that room. I think anyone who goes there, it's geared towards college students, but I feel like anyone goes there at an age where they're motivated, they will get something out of the workshop, and it's for free.
Free is good. Now, we didn't tell the date yet. It's February 8th, which is a Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And time start?
Yep, so it's February 8th from 11 to 2. Mm-hmm. I just want to give a shout out to the sponsors who were so generous. It's the Just Checking In, Mary Waldron. She does great work in the community. She's just a saint. Mutual Bank, Just Charnel, is always involved in the community. And Mass Hire. Our partners are Bridgewater State and the NAACP. They've been phenomenal. We've worked with them a bunch of times through our documentary premiere last year. Phyllis Ellis does a great job. So it's really a kind of a team effort. And then we have so many resource tables. So I just want it to be one place where, you know, if you're a student and you just want to know, you just want to talk to somebody on what to do, it's there. The opportunity is there.
It's networking. It's learning. Think about the opportunity you and I had. We had a TV studio in high school. You could actually touch the
right
stuff. You could use the stuff. You could learn how to edit. You could be talent. You can do everything. And the nice thing about cable access, the stations that are, you know, surrounding BCA, you can do a little bit of everything. Because when you go to the TV stations, you get pigeonholed. You're in a union, and you're a reporter, or a director, or an editor, or a cameraman. You don't necessarily get to cross the line.
Right.
Over here, you get to cross the line, and you can figure out what your niche is. And then there's all sorts of behind-the-scenes stuff. Some people don't like to be on TV, but they're great editors. I mean, you luckily like to do both. I was always joked to me that I had a face for radio, so I did more behind-the-scenes stuff other than election coverage and stuff like that.
Right.
I couldn't follow a football or a basketball if my life depended on it. But this is the way to network, and you found out young how to network and how to meet people, and you never know who you're going to meet if it's going to lead to another opportunity. So from here, you went to the mayor's office and continued the craft, continued to tell the mayor's story in his own words, in his own show,
right.
So in newspaper, you get edited out. You get 30 seconds on channel 25 or whatever station because, you know, usually if it leads, it bleeds. But you got to tell the story. Storytelling is where it's at. And then there's documentaries, there's film. There's so many different. It's Steve Roy, my buddy, used to always say, it's the only thing I can get paid to do that actually is fun and I like. It's not like flipping burgers or doing a chore or whatever like that. It can be boring. I still like to shoot. I got to go back to school and learn how to edit again because it's all, you know, mice moves. And I used to know every click and every whistle, but that's old school. Definitely can't call it a shoot. And you can't call it a deck anymore. It's
totally
different terms. And it crosses the boundaries. It's not just TV production per se. So I got the 1 minute cue. It's all I got left. And we're going to bring on one of the actors too and talk to him. What would you like to say in the final like 30 seconds?
Well, I just want everyone to come. It's 11 to 2. It's a good opportunity where it's free. And then NAACP is actually going to feed everybody who goes there. It's an opportunity to go network and meet people. It's a tangible workshop. You walk in, you can walk out the volunteer opportunity, walk out with an internship. And we have professional headshots too. If you want to take a picture, if you're an aspiring actor, it's an opportunity to take advantage of. It's free. We want you there.
Thanks for doing it, Noube.
Thank you so much.
We'll be part of it. We'll be back with more. You're watching Greater Brockton. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.